from the struggles of life, through trials, through tribulations, through toils, through sickness, through prison, even death, cannot separate me from the love of God, for I am an overcomer. Hey, Shabbat Shalom, everyone. It is Saturday, January 15th, 2022, and it is cold out here in Sugar Land, Texas. Well, I'm just chilling at the park, and I got my word. And so I'm about to share with you what I'm reading. And so let's go to Acts chapter 1, verse 8. It says, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you should be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the end of the earth." And so this is promised to all believers, that once the Holy Spirit has fallen upon them, that they will receive power. Power for what? Power to be a witness to Jesus Christ, the Son of God. And so I just want to share with you what I went through about 2 years ago. I was going through a bad demonic oppression. I mean bad. I don't know if anyone of you out there who's listening to me know that there are such things as demons, ghosts, evil spirit, whatever you call them. Well, I went through a time of my life where they actually tried to kill me. I'm serious. They tried to kill me for 6 months straight. I mean, every time I would go to sleep, I would get this sleep paralysis where they would hold me down and I couldn't move and I felt the entity inside the room. But glory to God that He has set me free. And it was because of the Holy Spirit. You see, when you have the Holy Spirit in you, you will receive power to live a life that is worthy, to live a life that is God-driven. You cannot live a life without the Holy Spirit in you. You cannot live a God-driven life without the Holy Spirit in you. No matter what you think or what you believe, you cannot live it. You need to have the Holy Spirit to have the power. So what does the Holy Spirit do? First of all, we have to understand who the Holy Spirit is. The Holy Spirit is God, and He lives inside of us. Once you receive Jesus and you accepted Him and you've been baptized, all you need to do is just invite Him and ask Him. So we can do that right now. We can stop and invite the Holy Spirit into our lives. So you ready? Say this prayer with me. Father God, thank you for giving your Son to die on the cross for my sins, your Son Yeshua. And right now, I want to live a life that is holy, that is full of power that comes from heaven. So right now, Holy Spirit, I ask you to forgive me also and come into my heart and come into my life and live inside of me. Lord, I cannot do this without you. I humble myself before you, and I welcome you, Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name, amen. So if you have said that prayer with me, you are now filled with the Holy Spirit. And now you must learn how to walk with Him. And the way you walk with Him is to renounce everything that is not of God, everything that's of the world, whether it's secular music, whether it's the things that you love, TV, music, programs, when you renounce those things and you let it go, and then you fill yourself up with more of the Word of God and the things of God, you will receive power. And I guarantee you, you will be able to do the things that God has called you to do. So go out and preach the kingdom of heaven.